إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أعاذنا الله وإياكم منها. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، لأن تقوى الله هي التي ينجى بها العبد يوم القيامة وفي هذه الدنيا أيضا. وقال المولى جل في علاه: ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا، يعني مخرجا من كل ضيق ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. وقال تعالى: ومن يتق الله يجعل له من أمره يسرا. If you have a taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make all your affairs easy, yusra. And if you see the difficult, you need to go back to the taqwa. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today I would like to share with you a beautiful hadith that's recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari. من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الله تبارك وتعالى. This hadith القدسي. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول فيه: من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب، وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه، ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه، فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به ويده التي يبطش بها ورجله التي يمشي بها، ولئن سألني لأعطينه ولئن استعاذني لأعيدنه، وما ترددت بشيء أنا فاعله. ترددي في قبض روح المؤمن يكره الموت وأكره مساءته. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this beautiful hadith is talking about حب الله تبارك وتعالى العبد. How far Allah loves His servant. And the hadith mentioned how we can earn the hubbullah, how we can earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. The servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah loves them. And they love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, saying I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's easy. But earning the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you, it's a great. It's the best you can ever earn in this dunya. In this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned one of the asbab, one of the reasons, one of the means that we can earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِالشَّيْءِ أحب إلي مما افترضت عليه. My servant, there is nothing can draw near to me, can make love him more than what I make wajib on him, more than the compulsory, the wajibat. Doing the salawat al-khamsa, doing the fast in Ramadan, giving the zakat, wearing hijab as a sister, this wajibat is the dearest thing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. is the closest thing and the fairest door that you can knock in order to enter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember, if you neglected the wajibat, if you are not doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to do it, then how you earn the hubbullah? Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this hadith, وَمَا يَزَالُ يَتَقَرَّبُ عَبْدِي بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. And my servant, if he adds up the wajibat, some voluntary ibadat, he's praying the salat al-wajib, and now he's adding the sunnah. Sunnah after dhuhr, sunnah after maghrib, sunnah after isha, sunnah before fajr, doing the sunnah, fasting Ramadan, fasting 6 days, shawal, doing this kind of ibadah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, will make my servant get closer and closer to me. Doing, helping the community, doing something that makes you love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah loves you back. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, my servant, more he does this sunan, this voluntary ibadah, more he gets close to me. And one of the things, brothers and sisters in Islam, that we can earn the hubbullah is the qira'at al-Qur'an. Recitation the Qur'an with tadabbur, with reflection, with thinking, with like trying to understand what you are reciting. I'm not saying to you recite every day a couple of juz, but I'm just reminding you, even if you can do a page or 2 pages, recite the Qur'an. And try to understand the meaning, even if you can use a translation into your own language, the language that you understand the most. In order to have this reflection, Allah says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَخْفَالُهَا. Don't they reflect the Qur'an? Don't they look at the Qur'an? This is a source from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a mail that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us. This is our booklet as a human being. Rather, it's every product that you go and you buy, there's a little booklet coming with it, saying how to use, manual. This shows easy way how to make this thing working. Am I right? The same thing when Allah created us. Because this company, when they made this, they know better than anyone else. And the one who made us is Allah Azza wa Jal, and He knows how we can survive in this dunya. Allah says, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدَى فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Allah is talking to Adam, talking to his wife Hawa. When Allah descends them to this earth, to this, He says, I will send to you and your offspring, to everybody, the humanity, I will keep sending a messenger. وَإِن مِّنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَى فِيهَا نَذِيرٌ. Every nation, Allah sends a messenger, a prophet, to guide them. And Allah says, anyone who follows the footsteps of the Qur'an, anyone who follows the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. فَلَا يَضِلُّ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَشْقَى فِي الْآخِرَةِ. There is no grief, there is no stress, there is no depression, there is no problem for you in this dunya and the next life. This is what Allah says. Abdullah ibn Abbas, Tarjuman al-Quran, says, anyone who follows this Quran, he will never be misguided in this dunya and the next life. And Allah says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي. Anyone who turned away his face, my remembrance, my recitation of Quran, remembering Allah, coming to the masjid. Anyone who says, well, I have a job, I have something to do, I don't have a time to masjid, I can't even pray the Jum'ah wal Jama'at, Allah says, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا. He will face a hardship life, very difficult, something that he cannot even fall asleep the night unless he has some sleeping pills. He will have a difficulty. More he earns the dunya, more he has this difficulty. Trouble. Life is coming from every corner and he cannot handle. And if you ask him how much money you have in the bank is like flowing, like full, like millions of dollars. But emptiness here. Because the Messenger ﷺ said, ليس الغنى عن كثرة العرض ولكن الغنى غنى النفس. Being a wealthy, being a rich, it's not means that you have a loss of money. But the true ghina, the truth is the content and happiness and satisfaction that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide into yourself, in your soul. So the soul feels alhamdulillah and happiness. Number two, as I said, brothers, recitation of the Quran is our cure. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءُ وَرَحْمَةُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, He is a rahmah for us. It's a cure for all our stress and disease that we have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Hudan wa shifa. Inside the Quran, there is a guidance and there is a health. This is how you earn. Recite every morning that you wake up. Before the sunset, try to open even one page of the Quran. And brothers and sisters in Islam, the number three, what makes us earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is remembering Allah azza wa jal all the time. الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ. Allah mentioned the believers, they remember Allah while they're standing up, while they're sitting down, even when they're laying down, they always remember Allah. Aisha radiallahu anha said, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ أَحْيَانِهِ. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Whether he has a wudu, whether he has, not always, you are not required to have a wudu in order to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know what happened? When you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is saying, Ana jalisu man dhakarani. I'm with the one who's remembering me. More you remember Allah, more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you. And you feel the strength and strongness, and you don't feel the fatigue. Some people, they can stay awake during the daytime. They have to take a couple of naps. They when it comes the night time, they can't fall asleep easy. Their life is so stressful. Fatima bint Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to the messengers, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the wife of Ali ibn Abi Talib, coming to the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she said, "O messenger of Allah, I need someone who's working for me, some serving me the home, because they have a lot of things I have to do. I'm doing the cleaning, I'm doing the dishes, I'm doing everything, cooking and all that. I need somebody to help me." And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Can I tell you something that if you do, you don't need any help?" She said, "Yes, O Messenger of Allah." He says, "When you are about to sleep the night time, say 33 times Subhanallah." This is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 33 times Alhamdulillah, and 34 times Allahu Akbar. That become 100. And if you do the night time that 100 times, Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah and Allahu Akbar, the strength will come to you. And then you feel the whole day joy and happy food and happiness, and you have a lot of energy that you don't know where this energy is coming from. But you have to say with intention. You have to say while you are saying, while you are remembering what you are receiving, the ajr, the reward. And the fourth thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, that can draw us close to Allah, that we can earn hubbullah tabarak wa ta'ala, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is saying and remembering the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوا بِهَا. Allah gets beautiful names. So when you call to Allah, use through these names. Ya Hayy Ya Qayyum, bi rahmatika astaghith, islih li shani kulli, wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfat 'ayn. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught his daughter Fatima to say this dua every morning and every afternoon, three times. Remembering Allah, saying the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ 99 إِسْمًا مَنْ أَحْصَاهَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala owns 99 names. This hadith is recorded in Bukhari. It's an authentic hadith. But there's a riwayah, narration, saying after that, which is Sunan al-Tirmidhi, saying, اللهم الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن, all the way in. And that riwayah is a da'if, it's a weak riwayah. But the first part, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ 99 إِسْمًا مَنْ أَحْسَنَهَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ, is an authentic في صحيح البخاري من حديث أبي هريرة. Brothers and sisters in Islam, remembering Allah Azza wa Jal, remembering the names of Allah, and using that names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into your daily life. Allahu al-Ghafoor, you ask in the Ghufran, you ask forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu al-Tawwab, Allah, all this, just use it as much as possible. And the sixth thing that brothers and sisters in Islam makes us get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is getting close to the people that loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. The mu'mineen, the believers, took them, those people, as a close friend. Wherever you can find them, whether they are at the masajid or at the work, get them as a close friend. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَا تُصَاحِبْ إِلَّا مُؤْمِنًا وَلَا يَأْكُلْ طَعَامَكَ إِلَّا تَقِيٍ. If you want to have a close friend, then took as a mu'min, a believer, the one who's reminding you if you forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who's saying, okay, it's the time for Maghrib, let's stand up, make a wudu, let's pray together, so and so forth. Get as a close friend, the believer. If you don't have a believer friend, then you must find. Don't take as a close friend the person who is not believing Allah. The person who is not staying away from the ma'asi wal dhunub. And if you don't do that, there's a loss of time that you are very easy and fragile. And you are ready to just follow whoever says something to you. And your friend might say to you, if you have a non-Muslim friend, tonight is a Saturday night. There's nothing else to do in this. We come from a school, we come from work. Let's have a drink. Let's go to the bars. Let's go to the nightclubs. And if you keep saying once or twice or three times, no, 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 maybe the last day you might say, okay, let's go. And then that's the end of your days and your life. One brother is around 60 years old, come to me, to my office. He says, Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Mahmoud. I want to just talk to you. A brother is moving forward. Jazakullah khair, the masjid is full. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Come close. He's about 60 years old. He said, brother, give me advice. And I'll keep asking him, before I give you advice, tell me your story. What happened to you? He's around 60, 58, 59, 60. And he says, brother, I did not get married. I don't have a job. I don't have anything. I just like homeless. And he keeps saying me all the bad things. And I said, tell me what happened to you. And he says, when I was about 22, 23 years old, friend of mine just said, come on, let's have a drink. And I said, no, I don't want to drink alcohol. He said, try. And he says, I'm still keep trying it. From that day, 823 until now. No life. No life. He's homeless. He's he lost everything in this dunya and the next life. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the one who continuously like drink alcohol, ka'abidi wathan, is just like somebody who's worshipping idol. Mudminul khamri ka'abidi wathan. It's very severe, very scary. And why that happened? Because of his bad friend. Allah says in the Quran, يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. Allah says, remember the day the zalim, the one who's a wrongdoer, bites his hands, not just a finger, out of regret and sadness. And he says, I wish if I follow the Messenger of Allah, if I follow the prophets of Allah, woe unto me. What makes me go with so and so individual? He's mentioning his non-believer friends. He's mentioning his bad friends who led him to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All these things that I mentioned and some more, brothers, if we apply our daily life, that makes us earning the love of Allah Azza wa Jalla. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bi asma'ihi al-husna wa sifatihi al-ulya an yaj'alana minhum innahu waliyyu dhalika wal qadiru alayhi. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى صلاة وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، أما بعد، Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you want to really earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's a time that the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your desires coming face to face, hitting collision. Who I should obey more? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger, or what my desires is commanding me? It happens that every day, every one of us, to begin with, when you are waking up the Fajr time, the shaitan is saying, you know what, there's a lot of time. The Fajr is just coming, it is about to come in. Don't worry. And then you stay in the bed until the sun rises and you say, oh no. And we never learn our mistake. We keep doing it the next day. So you just choose your sleeping over obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حديث أنس بن مالك في الصحيحين ثلاث من كن فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما وأن يحب المرء لا يحبه إلا لله وأن يكره أن يعود في الكفر بعد أن أنقذه الله منه كما يكره أن يقذف في النار. Having these three beautiful qualities, if you have these three qualities, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, then wajada halawat al-iman, then you earn the sweetness, the greatness of iman. Have you ever tasted the iman? Have you ever feel the sweetness of iman? Probably not. If you say, I've never had this three quality, and if you said yes, then you will feel it. You will feel it. Number one, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. To love Allah and His Messenger more than anyone. سواهما, including yourself. Your nafs is commanding you to see something haram. And Allah saying, don't look at it. قل للمؤمنين يغضوا من أبصارهم. قل للمؤمنات يغضوا من أبصارهن. And if you choose over Ridullah subhanahu wa ta'ala over yourself, then you feel the sweetness of iman. Man taraka shay'an lillah awwadahu Allahu khayran minhu. If you stay away something and avoid something for the sake of Allah, Allah will definitely replace you something better than what you walk away for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, wa an yuhibba al-mar'a la yuhibbuhu illa lillah. To love your Muslim brother, to love your Muslim sister, while you're loving nothing else but the face for the sake of Allah. Nothing, no other relation between you and him. You're not looking his skin color. You're not looking his gender. You're not looking his like wealth and everything. You love him for the sake of Allah because you saw him, he is so obedient to Allah. He's coming to the masajid. He's a believer. He's a mu'min. He's a taqi. So you love him because of that. وَأَن يُحِبَّ الْمَرْأَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. Sometimes you might think you love your brother for the sake of Allah. But that's a mistake that you are making. And how you realize that? When something happened between you and him. So small things about dunya. If you saw him that you're walking away from him, you are not responding his salam anymore, then you don't love him for the sake of Allah. You love him for the sake of something else. And the third and the last, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, وَأَن يَكْرَهَ أَن يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ. You have to hate to go back to the kufr that you used to be. Or the disobedient, if you born and raised in Islam, to go back to your situation. You used to be tarik salat, you are not praying, you are not fasting, but Allah give you the hidayah and you come to the masjid. Then try to avoid going back to your previous life. وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ كَمَا يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. Exactly the way you hate if somebody took you and drop you into the fire. And the last, brothers and sisters in Islam, that you can earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to avoid everything that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you the places that He loves. Whenever He look at you, you are praying, you are fasting, you are going to the masajid, you are obedient to Allah, you are trying to stay away the haram, then you will earn the love of Allah Azza wa Jalla for doing all that. Brothers and sisters in Islam, before I conclude the khutbah today, I would like to announce you this announcement, and I think most of you get. One of our sisters is missing. Her name is Nadia Atmi. She's around 32 years old, and she's a mom, and she's about 170 to 180 pound, and she's missing since December 6th. Brothers and sisters, if you find this sister, she is wearing a black hijab last time. She was wearing a black clothes, as they said it. So please contact immediately the police officers. So the phone number is 780-423-4567. Contact them, and we need to get Nadia back, inshallah ta'ala, as soon as possible. She was a teacher at the Islamic school. She's one of our sisters. And she's missing since the 8th of... She's a mother of kids. So inshallah ta'ala, let's all of us to take our responsibility. If we find this sister and her picture is there and here, so please call the police as soon as possible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. Allahumma rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab al-nar. Allahumma aghfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al-ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareeb mujib ad-da'awat. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وارحم لأمهاتنا. اللهم اغفر لأهل القبور من المؤمنين والمسلمين. اللهم من مات على التوحيد فاغفر له يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لهم وعافهم واعف عنهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذا المقام ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا مريضا إلا عافيته، ولا مبتلا إلا شافيته، ولا غائبا إلا رددته، ولا غائبا إلا رددته، ولا غائبا إلا رددته، ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمنا الله وإياكم.